My name is Dr. Katie Basham, and I'm a postdoctoral research fellow at the University of Michigan. And my research is focused on fighting adrenal cancer. So there's really been a desperate need to develop new strategies to treat ACC. And this is a major focus of our research lab. Our strategy to address this question has been to start with human tumors and to look for different genes that are altered in these tumors. And this is how we and others first associated a new gene with ACC. This gene is called ZNRF3, and this is the focus of my research. Now, ZNRF3 was actually found to be the most frequently altered gene in ACC, and interestingly, this gene is deleted or missing in the tumors. But when this gene was first associated with ACC, it was unclear what this gene normally did in the adrenal gland and why a tumor might want to get rid of it. So these have been the questions that I have been focused on answering. To answer these questions, I genetically engineered a mouse model that's missing this gene, ZNRF3, only in its adrenal gland, similar to what would happen in a human ACC patient. And then I looked to see what effect this had on the adrenal. And what I found was really a profound effect. When this gene is missing, the adrenal grows to be almost 10 times bigger than its normal size. So this told us that this gene, ZNRF3, is really critical in regulating the size of an adrenal. And you might imagine that a tumor would want to get rid of it so that it too can grow faster and more quickly. Now, in addition to looking at the effect of loss of ZNRF3 on the adrenal, we also looked at how this was happening at the molecular level. And what we found was that a particular signaling pathway called the Wnt signaling pathway was turned on. But what was most interesting was not just that this pathway was turned on or off, but it's really the level to which this pathway is turned on. Interestingly, when ZNRF3 is deleted, the pathway only turns on partway, and this is what is responsible for that profound effect on growth. So somewhat counterintuitively, if you turn the pathway all the way on, you don't see the same effect. Now moving forward, we're using this mouse model to look for therapies that are particularly good at targeting tumors that are lacking this gene. Finally, I want to thank the Heather Rose Cornick Research Fund and the American Cancer Society for funding this work.